Hey there guys! Welcome to part 4 of this Game Maker Studio tutorial. My name is Sparckman. Well, I'm Sparckman's computer, again. And I'm going to be your host for the next 3 minutes. How cool is that? A computer that talks, and makes tutorials. Whoa! You won't see that every day. Before we start, help me rank this video higher on YouTube, by simply leaving a like, or a dislike. Also, don't forget to drop a comment and let me know how much you hated this video. Or just say, I love potatoes. Every interaction helps the ranking on YouTube. Okay, so let's get started. Here is where we are so far. We have a character that can move on the screen and can turn around. He can go up and down, diagonally, and he has collisions, as you can clearly see, but I feel the need to tell you what's happening on the screen. But, we have a small problem. He doesn't have a walking animation. So, let's fix that. Let's simply double-click on our sprite. We're going to animate this sprite by simply adding a new frame. So let's copy and paste this frame. You can enable onion skin, so you can see the previous frame. This is a very nice tool for making sprite animations. I mentioned this before, but Game Maker Studio 2 has an amazing pixel art editor. Some people use Game Maker Studio as a pixel art editor. Okay, here is our new animation. Let's test the game. Our character is now animated. Wow! So that works great. Except for one little problem. His legs won't stop moving, and you want him to stop moving his legs once you stop pressing the arrows. Let's fix this by simply double-clicking on our object. Let's add a new event. I'm going to select Step Begin, which should really be called Start of Level, since this event only happens once. Let's make a variable. Just drag variable into the screen. Let's call this LeWalk. And for the value we are going to leave this at 0. Let's go to the left direction, and let's change the variable. We are going to change it to 1. So, when the user is pressing the left key, this variable will turn 1. I'm just going to copy and paste the same variable to all the directions. Right. Down. And up. If you run the game, you will notice that nothing happens. Let's add a new step event. If you are new to Game Maker, step events are events that are always running. So, let's drag an if statement. If LeWalk is equal 0, then we set our animation speed to 0. Let's drag another if statement. This time we are going to make it so if LeWalk is set to 1, which is when the user presses any of the arrows, then we are going to set our animation speed to 8. Run the game, and let's see what happens. Okay. Maybe it's a bit too slow. Let's try 9. Try it out. See what we get this time. Wow, that works much better. I have to say, this was very, very easy. Anyone can do this. If you hated this video, hit that dislike button. But if you liked this, smack that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. And hit that bell next to the subscribe button. Okay, that's it guys. See you in part 5 of this video. Bye now.